You know, up till now, most people are still skeptical about cryptocurrency, investing in cryptocurrency, or putting their money in cryptocurrency, or having anything related to cryptocurrency because they think that their government is disapprove of it. All right. Right now, the Nigerian government is launching its first e-currency, or you can call it crypto e-currency, by 1st of October. Okay, if I'm not mistaken, and it's been all over the news. It's just been all over the news.
In other news, the Central Bank of Nigeria is set to launch the pilot scheme of its digital currency on October 1st, 2021. The governor of the Apex Bank, Mr. Godwin Emefiele, was reported to have announced this during the 306th Bankers Committee meeting held via private webinar. The press briefing delivered by the Director of IT Department, Mrs. Rekia Mohammed, at the end of the meeting explained that the bank had been conducting research in regarding to central banks digital currency since 2007.
So you remember earlier this year Nigerian government banned cryptocurrency, anything that has to do with cryptocurrency transaction. If your transaction contains anything that has to do with crypto, they'll block your account or ban you from using that bank, or just restrict your account totally. All right, so it made things a bit difficult at the moment for people, and then people had to switch to P2P mode of transacting through crypto. And then most crypto industry that were operating at the time shut down. Binance even stopped withdrawal or the direct deposit with card in Nigeria, and then Nuno totally shut down. Most people's phones were shut off. But now the same government are trying to, launch their own e-currency. So this is what I'm telling you guys. Let us not be deceived. Let us know where exactly the world is pushing into. And your Binance should already have a tips of it. But some few groups of people are just trying to make this just something that they can control, so that they can be much more beneficial to that thing than the rest of us. And in the bid of trying to do that, they try to make a whole lot of person suffer it by restricting a whole lot of person. When they find out that they can't actually restrict everyone, and they can't actually restrict the kind of growth that is going on within the industry, they try to join in or fall in, or try to have major control over it. So if your government banned cryptocurrency, and in the same season are launching their own e-currency, so what do you think of it? So it's better you guys start thinking of that. Start thinking of much more ways to earn in cryptocurrency. And recently, I discovered that an hourly wage in UK is about $8.28 per hour. And let's say you are earning $200K in Nigeria. $200K is about $277. It's about $277, if I'm not mistaken, $200K, based on the exchange rate as at the moment now. Which means it literally takes somebody 3 days to work in the UK to earn the someone's entire monthly salary. See that? So if you're a Nigerian, you're watching this video, I know majority of the viewers of these videos are always from USA, Philippines, but if you're from all this area, you can also take something from this video, because I believe your government is also trying to do one or two. But if you are from Nigeria, I believe it's time for you to diversify and start taking some good advices, start taking something really good. Affiliate marketing, forex marketing, crypto trading, all right? Most of you that cannot trade crypto, I have already made a video on the app or on Royal Q. You you buy the trading board and then you start using it totally free, low risk trading, and then set it up properly, and then you earn in dollars, and then you earn good money. Here is a proper documentary about the e-naira that is about to be launched on October 1st. So watch it properly and understand it from the direction that they are coming from and what you stand to expect from them. So just go through it. It's important.
October 1st is Independence Day in Nigeria, and also a big day in tech. Welcome to the era of central bank digital currency, CBDC. The digital version of Naira, e-Naira, is launching in Lagos, Abuja, Port Harcourt, and Kano by the CBN. And this is coming after the crypto and Twitter ban. So what does this mean for you? Well, for starters, it means that you will be able to receive and spend the e-Naira. But how? Well, like any digital currency, you will need an electronic wallet to receive, hold, and spend it securely, which is basically an app you would download on your phone. For the pilot program, Project Giant, the name CBN is calling it, the banks will handle the process, probably with a selected group of tech-savvy early adopter customers. An invitation code will be sent to you from your bank. That's if you are selected. You will be directed to either a website or an app store if you are on iPhone or iPad, or to a Play Store if you're on Android, to download the wallet app. Once your app is downloaded, enter the invitation code. If valid, you will proceed to register, set password, BVN, email, phone, get verified, and your e-Naira wallet is created. Simple. Okay, now you have a wallet. What next? Top up, of course. How do you fund it? You can receive e-Naira from another e-Naira holder from their wallet, or you can transfer from your bank account to your e-Naira wallet. Naira for e-Naira. That is, credit your wallet from your bank app, the bank that invited you, or a different bank. All that is possible. For example, if Zenith Bank sent you an invite to set up your e-Naira wallet, you can use your Zenith Bank account app to transfer some Naira to your e-Naira wallet. Or you can use your ZTB Bank app to transfer to your e-Naira wallet with Zenith Bank. Either way, you get your e-Naira. How do you spend it? You can spend your e-Naira through wallet-to-wallet transfer, or wallet to bank account within the same bank or outside with another bank, in which case you will enter a bank account, then initiate a transfer. But e-Naira to cash withdrawals are not allowed. No. You can't just go to the ATM and start withdrawing cash from your e-Naira wallet. It's the digital economy, hence cashless. On the other hand, you can convert your cash to e-Naira. Take it to a registered agent or your bank branch, and they will credit your e-Naira wallet with the amount you deposited. Expect a barrage of campaigns and ads in the time running up to October 1st. Individuals, merchants, businesses, government institutions will be onboarded to the e-Naira platform to test run and possibly give feedback to strengthen the system before the next stage of rollout. So, e-Naira is here to usher in a new digital era to facilitate payments. Person to person, person to business, person to government. Talking about government, expect that all your payments between you and the government will be through the e-Naira in stages henceforth. I'm talking about salary payments for government workers, taxes, insurance, passport, driver's license, registrations and renewals, utility bills, and all other transactions that involve you and the government, and service providers. Exciting times ahead. I personally think that the e-Naira digital currency is much more than money and payment. It's going to be a platform where other businesses will thrive on, especially in the fintech industry. If you look at the underlying technology powering the whole process, it's going to be much easier to access funds, make payments, and more importantly, control the financial sector, especially when it comes to foreign exchange. You will be seeing a lot of products coming out based on the e-Naira, very innovative products, I'm saying. Digital goods, e-commerce, imports and exports, financial derivatives, and all kinds of innovations can be built on this system. Okay, now, I know what you're thinking. Is this any different from cryptocurrency? Central bank digital currency, CBDC, has some similarities as well as differences from cryptocurrency. But you won't see most of that from the name. They are similar in the underlying technology. Both are digital and based on the blockchain, a highly secure database in which all transactions are stored. The main difference, though, is that CBDCs are permissioned. by a central authority and issued into existence, while cryptocurrencies are permissionless, meaning they are public, and mined into existence, meaning they are created cryptographically. That's just it. Any other explanation is just icing on the cake. Both currencies are networks of platforms where digital assets like money, currencies, can be exchanged securely, on top of which other derivative assets can be built. Now, I say securely because of the blockchain, a ledger protected by cryptography. All other benefits are cherry on the pie, like fast transactions and cheaper processing. So what do you think about the eNaira?
So that's what this video is all about. So I hope you enjoyed the video. Please subscribe for more.